to the first episode of Today on Commodities Market. I am Precious Destiny. Now, the Vice President Yemi Osinbajo said there is a need to focus on developing the agricultural value chain, particularly the business of guaranteeing the creation of a proper commodity market with the right logistics that would be mutually beneficial to farmers and consumers. He made this assertion while receiving a delegation from a commodity market and exchange firm. According to Professor Osinbajo, and I quote, "We are top producers of so many different agricultural products as well as minerals. It is in adding value, ensuring the value chain works effectively, ensuring that we can process, store and trade. That's really where the missing link is." He lauded the idea of a private commodity exchange, noting that a private commodity exchange is very important. In other stories, the Central Bank of Nigeria has expressed its determination to address the existing challenges in the country's wheat value chain as part of efforts to shore up the country's foreign reserves. The CBN Director, Development Finance Department, Philip Yusuf, highlighted the enormous potential of the wheat value chain for groundbreaking impact in the agricultural sector at the Wheat Conference and Stakeholder Engagement. According to Yusuf, wheat was the second highest contributor to the country's food import bill, putting pressure on the country's foreign reserve as over $2 billion was spent annually on the importation of over 5 million metric tons of wheat. He estimated that only 1% of wheat out of the 5 to 6 million metric tons of wheat consumed annually was produced locally, and that the CBN intervention had become critical due to the high demand for wheat in Nigeria and the inability to meet the demand. Moving on, as recently released, the value of manufactured goods imported into the country exceeded exports by 4.37 trillion naira in the second quarter of 2021, according to figures obtained from the National Bureau of Statistics. The NBS stated that the value of manufactured goods trade in quarter 2 2021 stood at 4.51 trillion naira, representing 37.50% of total trade. According to report, export component accounted for 211.67 billion naira, while the import component was valued at 4.3 trillion naira. The product had drove up manufactured products where vessels and other floating structures from breaking up, which was exported to Cameroon in the value worth 71.9 billion naira. It added that vessels and other floating structures for breaking up were also exported to Spain and Equatorial Guinea in values worth 18.34 billion naira and 6.62 billion naira respectively. The MBS report stated that all the products under the group were aluminium alloys and exported to Japan in the value worth 10.85 billion naira and China 3.63 billion naira. In terms of manufactured imports, it added, used vehicles were mainly imported from United States and Italy in values worth 33.78 billion naira and 5.74 billion naira respectively. The Oil Commodity Group Import Index increased by 0.82% between January and March 2021, according to the National Bureau of Statistics disclosed in its report on commodity price indices and terms of trade for the first quarter of 2021. According to MBS, the upturn was driven mainly by an increase in the prices of mineral products, 1.53%, live animals, animal products, 1.38%, and animal and vegetable fats and oil, and other cleavage products, 1.24%. The report, however, added that the index was negatively affected by declines in the prices of products of the chemicals and allied industry, minus 0.36%, as well as wood, charcoal and articles, minus 0.29%. Between January and February, the Oil Commodity Group Import Price Index increased by 0.75%. This was driven by increases in the import prices of animal and vegetable fats and oil and other cleavage, 1.77%, mineral products, 1.63%, and live animals, animal products, 1.37%. The increase was, however, offset by decline in the price of products of the chemical and allied industries, minus 0.73%, and wood and articles of wood, wood charcoal and articles, minus 0.58%. Between February and March 2021, the All Commodity Group Import Index grew by 0.07%, driven by increase in the prices of base metals and articles of base metals 0.51%, boilers, machineries and appliances 0.50%, among others. In the gas sector, the average price for the refilling of 12.5 kg cylinder for cooking gas increased by 2.09% month on month and by 9.14% year on year to 4,514.82 naira in August 2021 from 4,422.32 naira in July 2021. It currently sells for 7,200 as at September ended 2021, showing a sharp increase of 93%. Now over to the market prices for the week. The market price of maize increased from 17,900, which is 12.48%, to the range of 22,862 naira and 25,000 naira. Soybean 37,783 to 39,000 naira. Rice 21,494 to 25,000, and there are possibility it will rise as the year comes to an end. Sorghum ranges from 20,304 to 22,000. The price of cocoa is between 91,235 to 93,000. Ginger is between 127,362 to 130,000. Sesame is between 48,117 naira to 49,000. Cashew 44,500 naira to 45,000. However, Nigerians will be plagued by hunger and malnutrition as food prices continue to spike. Market survey indicates that a bag of beans now sells for as high as 100,000 naira. Other prices are reliant on the region. Now over to the mineral resources. Gold price per gram today is $56.76. International market, silver price per gram, $0.73. 1 gram of gold price in Nigeria is 23,360.14 naira. And that's all we can take on today on Commodities Market. I am Precious Destiny. Thanks for watching. Don't forget, it's all about commodities. Bye for now.